Hello dear friends, this is Lit eCity, the YouTube channel dedicated to English literature. We are here once again with the new installment of MCQ Marathon, where we discuss some important works, some great novels, writers, poems, which help you to understand the major concepts, some major works of the 20th century. I hope you have enjoyed the previous installments of this series. This is the 15th installment, and we will start this particular video with our first question related to Graham Greene. He is one of the most popular and also critical acclaimed novelist of the whole 20th century. In this particular question, you have to match the novels of Graham Greene with the respective protagonist. My dear friends, Graham Greene, he wrote in his own words two types of novel. One were mere entertainment, and the other set was related with we can say deeply philosophical and religious themes. On one side, on our left side, we have the name of the novels like Breton Rock, The Power and the Glory, The End of the Affair, The Heart of the Matter. Let me briefly introduce you with the story of these novels. For example, Breton Rock, it is a gripping reflection on the nature of evil, and there is a clash between, there is one detective Ida and also another protagonist, which you will find in these four names. If we talk about The Power and Glory, it is a story of a Roman Catholic priest. You got the idea actually by this one, and he is living in the Mexican state of Tabasco in 1930s. It was a time when the Mexican government was trying to suppress the Catholic Church. If we talk about The End of the Affair, it is about the obsessions, jealousy, discernments, and there are three central characters. One among them is among these list, another is Sarah Miles and her husband, who is a civil servant, Henry Miles. And if we talk about The Heart of the Matter, it is set during World War II in a bleak area of West Africa. The settings are also very important, and it concerns the moral dilemmas related with the central character, who is an honorable deputy commissioner of police, and he is torn between on one side his compassion, pity and love for his wife Lizzie, and similarly he also loves a young widow, Helen. So these are four novels, brief summary of these four novels, and now you have these options as usual. But let me tell you very very quickly, the options here are quite easy. It matches the similar. First, it is Pinky, who is the protagonist, or we can say anti-hero of the story Breton Rock. Then we have unnamed whiskey priest. Now pay special attention to this term, whiskey priest. It was a term coined by Graham Greene himself. End of the Affair, it is the writer, it is the protagonist is the writer Morris Bandrick. And the last one, Henry Scobby, one of the most popular characters created by Graham Greene. So our answer is A, B, C and D. Okay, moving to our second question. Which novel of Evelyn Waugh describes the misfortunes of Paul Pennefeather, who is an innocent living abroad in the decadent world of the fashionable 1920s society? Dear friends, like Graham Greene, Evelyn Waugh is also a Catholic writer. His novel deals with some problems, some dilemmas of being a Catholic in largely Protestant society, and there we can say both have written some deeply religious novels, not in the traditional religious sense, but in the modern we can say existential point of view, the religious novels. So our options are, First is wild bodies, second is a handful of dust, third is decline and fall, and the last is the ordeal of Gilbert Pinfold. Now, all novels are very popular. Evelyn Waugh is one of the most prominent writers of the mid-20th century. His work have given inspiration to the later generation. Let me first tell you the answer for this question, then we will discuss all these novels briefly. Decline and Fall. Decline and Fall is the novel in which we have this particular character, Paul Pennefeather, who is an innocent, and he is living in this decadent world which Evelyn Waugh has attacked again and again. For example, even in this novel Wild Bodies, it is like a chronicle of empty hedonistic culture. It is a satire, it is about the hedonism of, and the term we can say, roaring 20s. Roaring 20s is the term which is used for the generation who, after the end of the First World War, they were living a life of luxuries, and there were a group of bright young things. Another very important and popular cultural term of that time, bright young things. They were ready to take risks, and their life was quite bohemian and living in hedonistic fashion. And it is all about, the name of the hero of this novel, please remember, it is Adam Symes. Also remember this name, Adam Symes, Adam Frederick Fenwick Symes. Then we have A Handful of Dust. It is once again a savage portrayal of the idleness and decadence of these bright young things, and it is through the relationship, deteriorating marriage of Lady Brenda Last, who is very beautiful, but she is a shallow, without moral young woman, and her husband Tony. So Brenda Last and Tony, character of A Handful of Dust. Decline and Fall, we have already discussed about Paul Pennefeather. And The Ordeal of Gilbert Pinfold is almost autobiographical account of a period of hallucination. It was caused by intake of bromide intoxication, which Evelyn Waugh himself experienced during the period of 1954. So these are the four works and their brief introduction. Okay. Our next question is about an interesting genre, that is radio play. Okay, now you have to tell in which popular radio play there is an omniscient narrator who invites the audience to listen to the dreams and innermost thoughts of the inhabitants of the fictional Welsh fishing village Leirgub. So, as you can understand, radio play is rather, 20th century phenomena or genre in which a play is recited on broadcast, on radio broadcasting, and there are some, very popular dramatists who have explored this particular modern technique of drama. The options are, let me tell you in advance, all these plays are radio plays. So first one is Samuel Beckett's All That Fall, Dylan Thomas Under Milkwood, Harold Pinter's A Slight Ache, and Robert Bold's A Man for All Seasons. Okay, dear friends, first let me tell you the answer. You can guess. देखिए ये भी एक तरीका होता है, when you are attempting NET exam and you don't know the options, look carefully at the options, at the question also. There is Welsh fishing place. We know very well Beckett is Irish, Pinter and Robert Bold, they are British, and Dylan Thomas, though he is he writes in English, but we know that he is a Welsh background writer. So you have this idea, and yes, this is the right answer. Dylan Thomas Under Milkwood, it is his radio drama about this fictional town Leirgub. Let me also introduce two other plays. For example, All That Fall, it focuses on the character of Maddie Rooney, who is addressing her relationship to her husband, Dan Rooney. In this particular, typical in the vein of Beckett plays, it is an absurdist play. If we talk about Pinter's A Slight Ink, it is about a married couple's dreams and desires, and it focuses mostly on husband's fear of the unknown, of growing old. And if we talk about Robert Bolt's A Man for All Seasons, we have already covered in a previous questions, it is based on life of famous Elizabethan figure Sir Thomas More. Please try to remember these extra bit of information. Okay, moving ahead to our next question. The writer whose study of Hindu traditional wisdom, it resulted in a translation with the, along with Swami Prabhavanand, and he translated Bhagavad Gita in 1944. Then he wrote Vedanta for the Western world in 1945. And he also wrote My Guru and His Disciple, published in 1980. These are a persuasive presentation of his religious re-education under the influence of, we can say, Eastern philosophy, Eastern mysticism. Now you have to tell the name of this writer. We know that in whole 20th century there were many writers who were greatly influenced by the Eastern philosophy and Hindu religion. W.B. Yeats, T.S. Eliot, Aldous Huxley, there are many. So our options are Christopher Isherwood, Aldous Huxley, Ralph Waldo Emerson the American, and Hermann Hesse the German writer. All these are more or less influenced by our Indian or Hindu religion. Let me tell you the right answer first. It is Christopher Isherwood. Yes, the writer who along with W.H. Auden is a group of Mac Spender group, and he is, we can say, one of the writer who has come Marxist inclination, and along he has collaborated with Auden also in writing some plays, and he translated Bhagavad Gita. Side by side, let me tell you, inform you that Aldous Huxley wrote the introduction to this translation of Bhagavad Gita, and also which was translated by Sherwood. Emerson, his most famous poem, it is titled Brahma, which is about the pure being, unknowable and formless. And Hermann Hesse, who can forget this Nobel Prize winner writer's famous work Siddhartha. Our last question is about another Nobel Prize recipient, and this is, you have to match the novel with the theme, these works written by Kazuo Ishiguro, the Japanese novelist based in England. And he writes very, we can say, very beautifully, poetically about the pastimes. So first novel is The Pale View of Hills, which was published in 1982. An Artist of the Floating World, published in 1986. The Remains of the Day, published in 1989. And The Unconsoled, published in 1995. Okay, let me directly go to the answer. First, Pale View of Hills. It is basically about relationship between Atsuko, who is a widow, and her westernized daughter, and they are haunted by suicide of her older daughter. This is about a plain view of hills. Okay, An Artist of the Floating World. It is about Masuzi Ono, who was once a distinguished painter. Now he looked back on a career which is full of ups and downs in his old age. The Remains of the Day, one of the most popular works by Ishiguro. It is about Stevens, who is a butler at Darlington Hall in England, and how he sacrifices his emotional life, his love life, for the sake of greatness in his profession, though in the end he pursues his own happiness. And obviously the last one is The Unconsoled, which is reflection of another artist, a pianist, Mr. Ryder, as he visits his hometown. So please, friends, go through these novels. He is also a prominent writer, we can say one of the latest classical writer who write in a traditional form, and all these works are very important. I hope you are basically finding these videos worthy of your time. If you like them, please share with your friends, subscribe to the channel, and please give your important feedback about this question: how can we improve the quality of all these videos? Thank you, friends.